let's take a look at this week's hobby happenings. Well, to kick things off, Love of the Game Auctions is offering email subscribers a free ebook by David Cycleback titled Authenticating Early Baseball Cards. It's really a must-own, it seems, for pre-war collectors. The book serves as a guide for authenticating and detecting fakes, forgeries, reprints, counterfeits, and alterations. With the current trimming scandal having recently spilled over to cards from this era, the book's release couldn't have come at a better time. Additionally, the skills and techniques taught throughout the book can be applied to cards from other eras as well. To download your free copy, simply visit bit.ly/LOTG ebook. So that's bit.ly/LOTG for Love of the Game ebook. And enter your email address and you can download it in ebook form.
Sounds like a deal. I'm going to go ahead and do that right now. No, I'm going to tell you this story first because this guy is a super collector. I want you to meet Adam Figlioli. To say that he is a Tom Brady fan would be an understatement. Adam has a ticket from every college and NFL game ever played by the GOAT. That stands for Greatest of All Time ebook, bit.ly.com. Yes, every single game. Adam's quest began during New England's 2007 undefeated regular season. He told the Taunton Daily Gazette, quote, "I used to go to a lot of games with my dad, and I never threw the stubs out and just put them in a shoebox. Then 2007 rolls around, and they had this historic, they had an undefeated season, and I thought it might be great to get a ticket from each game that season. I went on eBay, Craigslist, and acquired tickets. I got one for each game and was bummed out and ticked off when they lost the Super Bowl. I put them away, and then around 2008 or 2009, I figured I'd try collecting a ticket from every one of Brady's wins," which is, what, 98% of their games? "And it grew from there. I figured I'd try to get every game, regular season, and postseason." Well done, Adam. Well done.
Wow. That's amazing. As an entertainment collector, I've always thought if one sitcom in the history of television truly deserved a trading card set, it was Seinfeld. I even actually wrote an article about the idea a while back and actually created the checklist with subsets, chase sets, autograph, prop, and wardrobe relics, the works. Sadly, a licensed Seinfeld trading card set never materialized until now, sort of. You see, last Friday night was the 30th anniversary of the show's first episode. The New York Mets commemorated the event with Seinfeld Night, and patrons received a four-card set featuring Jerry, Elaine, Kramer, and George. Attendees also received a Jerry Seinfeld bobblehead, which have already become a hot commodity on eBay. The comedian himself was on hand throughout the first pitch and spent some time in the announcer's booth alongside iconic former guest star Keith Hernandez. Watch this.
I got to ask you a question.
Yeah, that's what this whole thing is about, Keith. This note needs to introduce the question going to ask you a question.
Did you ever bomb out on stage? Bomb?
First of all, bomb out. That's what my mother says, all right? Nobody says that, Keith. And Harper strikes out. He bombed out.
All right, now do baseball.
All right, here we go. One out, 2-2 count on Reese Hoskins, whose parents decided, let's spell his name as weirdly as possible. There's a little looper. It's good drop. No, it doesn't. Michael Conforto, who is not a natural center fielder, comes in and makes a nice grab.
Very good. Well, Jerry, this is always great, and I wish we could keep you longer.
Yes, we could be here all night.
Yes.
Thank you guys so much for inviting me in on Bobblehead Night. And let's make this more of a regular thing.
Yes.
That would be fantastic. That would be wonderful. Thank you.
Thanks, Gary. Thanks, Ronnie. Jerry. So glad
Thank
you're
you
back.
So much.
Great
Thank
to
you.
See you.
Thank
great
you.
Pitch, Bob.
Great to see you, my
Thank
friend.
You again for the, on the pitch. There I am, 65 years old, and he humped it in there.
Thanks to Rich Miller at Sports Collectors Daily for catching that story over the weekend. Well, this past week, MLB hosted its annual Midsummer Classic, the All-Star Game, in Cleveland, Ohio. The Play Ball Park, formerly known as All-Star Fan Fest, played host to a wide variety of attractions for baseball fans and collectors alike. David Hunt, president of Hunt Auctions, was on hand offering free memorabilia appraisal services. Sports Collectors Daily reports that among the items that showed up on Saturday was a high-quality 1948 Cleveland Indians team-signed baseball that included team owner Bill Veeck, who signed right above Satchel Paige and featured
Bill Veeck,
Bob Feeler on the sweet spot. Watch this.
This in the original box. Earlier in the day, he brought this and about three other baseballs in. So we appraised this one right in that probably $1,000 to $2,000 range. But when you have one in this kind of condition grade, it could easily bring two or three times that amount of money once it goes to auction. So we evaluated this one for him. In addition to a couple others that he had, including a Red Sox ball from the late 1930s, it did have a secretarial signature of Jimmy Fox on it, so the value was not clearly as much on that one.
And this is a pristine 1948 Indians team ball.
Wow.
I think that's amazing. Paige, Satchel Paige, and Bill Veeck on the
right,
same line.
Yes, right on the same panel. Just an amazing piece here.
Sweet. Collector and attorney Paul Lesko, who writes the Law of Cards articles for Cardboard Connection, made several hobby-related legal announcements this past week. Panini filed a trademark infringement lawsuit against eBay seller Collector's Vault. The complaint alleges that Collector's Vault regularly uses Panini's rated rookie logo mark to sell cards on eBay, and that's obviously a no-no. Pictured are a few examples from the complaint below. Panini says it attempted to go through eBay's Vero program to stop these sales prior to bringing suit, but because the items are still for sale, it needed to file legal action. Lesko noted that, quote, "This isn't an overly complex suit. Panini owns registrations for Rated Rookie in association with trading cards. So if Collector's Vault doesn't have permission to use the Rated Rookie mark, well, that would likely equal infringement." A couple of trademark applications were recently filed by Upper Deck, one for the official trading card of esports for lots of different types of goods, including trading cards, bumper stickers, magazines, temporary tattoos, desk calendar, and lunch bags, just to name a few. Well, this trademark application actually could face a legal challenge from Panini. Both Upper Deck and Panini each have licenses for trading cards with separate esports leagues, making Upper Deck's application for the official trading card of esports somewhat murky. Also, it looks like this year's national attendees just might be able to score Fleer and Fleer Ultra t-shirts at the Upper Deck booth. Why? Well, the company filed trademark applications for both Fleer and Fleer Ultra to use on clothing. So maybe, just maybe, we can score a Fleer Ultra shirt, Ivan.
It's about time. No, I'm very happy about that, and that'll be a lot of fun. The 2019 live auction at MLB All-Star Play Ball Park, presented by Hunt Auctions, features several high-profile items, including this rare Babe Ruth professional model game bat with specific provenance dating to his early career. Sports Collectors Daily reports that the bat was originally obtained by a Philadelphia boy who lived directly across the street from, mock me, Shibe Park?
Shibe.
In Philadelphia, and got to know Ruth and other players. The bat sold for $200,000. Hunt Auctions president and founder David Hunt talks about memorabilia authenticity with Fox 8 reporter Ed Gallick. Check it out.
A 1948 Indians ball. This is a panoramic photograph, and to have survived, you know, over 100 years now in this pristine condition, especially with the dollar values that these pieces are bringing, you really need to be sure of who you're dealing with.
Buy something you see here, it'll cost hundreds to hundreds of thousands of dollars. But the folks at Hunt Auctions do more than you might ever imagine to make sure their sports memorabilia is legit. Consider how they checked out this bat used by Babe Ruth.
The markings on the bat, the dash, dot, dash in, is indicative of the date that they used it. You'll also notice the lathe marks on the end. This was not a bat made for retail sale. This was a bat made for professional use. Identification traits, sort of where Ruth hit, label up, label down. It's pretty intricate.
None of them are real, and all of them are bad takes.
Last year, the I-Team showed you Cleveland police raided a suspected con man with a stand at the IX Center during a national sports memorabilia show. Now, with huge crowds expected here for All-Star Weekend, a word of caution, buying collectibles.
We're just going to take the sport.
As you look at the silver gelatin in the surfacing, the age, the imagery quality.
Meet the 1910 Indians. Hunt Auctions sends collectibles through layers of checks. And if you bring memorabilia downtown to Playball Park this weekend, the company will evaluate your stuff at no charge.
Let's go back to when I was a kid, way back in the early 70s. I collected baseball cards, and maybe you did too. I kept a bunch of them, and I brought some of them here just to find out. What might they be worth now?
I got some Indians and some Pirates here.
And that's actually pretty nice. You know, it's got a corner ding, but it's pretty clean in the middle.
My card's nice. Not worth much, but we're showing you all of this so you can protect yourself.
Be positive that you've got the right item, an authentic item, not just one that maybe seems too good to be true.
You know, it never ceases to amaze me that you really can learn something new in this hobby of ours every single day. Take this photo of two of the greatest players of all time at the plate, comparing their tools of the trade with bold signatures from each. Well, it turns out that despite both being prodigious signers throughout their careers, this is the only known photo autographed by just Babe Ruth and Ty Cobb. It will be featured in a Heritage Auctions event later this summer. Crazy.
A fresh find of cardboard treasure that includes a huge stash of pre-war cards will be making its way to the hobby. Sports Collectors Daily reports that a small fortune of cards has been tucked away in a box as a sort of curious heirloom appreciated for a long time by a family of sports lovers. Now the grandchildren, who have recently inherited the collection of more than 700 cards, have consigned it as part of this August's Heritage Platinum Night auction. The collection is filled with baseball icons, including Cobb, Wagner, Jackson, LaJoy, Johnson, Gehrig, and of course, Ruth. A bunch of Babe Ruth cards, actually, including one that's a really, really rare issue that's about to enter the hobby for the first time. The box held stacks of T205s and T206, Carmel cards, Fatima team cards, a stack of 1933 Gaudis, including all four Ruth, and even a small group of original Old Judge cards from the 19th century. Yeah, that's the 1800s. But the real treasure? This extremely rare Babe Ruth M101-5 rookie card with the Famous and Bar branding on the back, of which only six have ever been graded and authenticated. In case you're wondering what that is, well, Famous and Bar was a St. Louis department store that ran promotions similar to the one featured in this ad for everybody's department store. Heritage had sold a low-grade example back in 2017 for over $90,000. However, this one graded a PSA 6 because the family was not afraid to have it professionally graded and is expected to sell for $300,000 or more.
Jeez.
I think the term for that is hobby porn.
The latest Topps X collection, speaking of porn, is now available through Topps.com. During this year's spring training, Topps sat down with Francisco Lindor to collaborate on creating his very own trading card set. The finished product developed in that creative meeting captures the essence of Francisco Lindor, his energy and swag, his love of the game's history and its future, and his personal heritage. The collector's edition of the set, which retails for $49.99, consists of 25 generational icon base cards, 12 Puerto Rican heritage inserts, and 15 2011 MLB draft class inserts. In addition, every set includes one autographed card, or one Lindor cleat relic card or Lindor bat relic card. The autograph checklist is pretty tight, with collectors having a chance at pulling signatures of players like Pete Alonso, Eloy Jimenez, Aaron Judge, Ken Griffey Jr., and, of course, Francisco Lindor himself, just to name a few. You can visit tops.com for more info.
Two incredible pieces of modern sports memorabilia will be sold this summer. The fielding gloves used by Chris Bryant and Anthony Rizzo when they fielded the final out in the 2016 World Series to end the Chicago Cubs championship drought of 108 years are headed to the auction block on August 1st in Chicago via a Golden Auctions event coinciding with the National Sports Collectors Convention. All I want to know is, can I put my hand in the glove first? Sorry, doing the news. Blowout Buzz reports that both gloves are signed and inscribed by the players to note their historic status, with documentation from both MLB Authentication and Fanatics, which handled autograph signings with the championship team. They are being sold as a single lot with an opening bid of $250,000.
An opening bid. And that's a look at this week's hobby happenings.